board, please.
Here in the work area, you only have 1 minute until we reach the halfway mark of the feature event. At that point, no time is given. Look at the change in the work area pullback. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to sit back, relax, and enjoy 33. think you proved his worth on that one.
Absolutely.
Last year there was a lot of people on social media that were kind of scoffing at the fact that this somewhat unknown kid in Oklahoma was going to drive for Keith Good Motorsports, and he came out, won his prelim night, and then grabbed the podium on Saturday. Has had all 2020 in his sport experience, and he backed it up here tonight.
He did. Last year, third in the main event, was fifth in USAC points, second in PowerEd points, 8-digit wins this year. I think the kid that impressed me the most tonight, Jacob Denny.
Oh, wow.
Talk about capitalizing on an opportunity, much like Cannon did a year ago. Jacob just celebrating his 16th birthday the other day, and a top 10 run for him tonight. Pretty darn impressive.
Not a bad run for a kid that wheeled modified to pick up 7 positions. Blake Vaughn, another impressive run there, had the caution not come out. He kind of showed him off the sunshine. You have to wonder, as he maybe could have locked himself in. He picked up 9 spots tonight. Tip agreed. Super served. He picked up 11 spots. And Garrett Taylor picked up a dozen positions tonight. Jake, I don't think anybody can argue that track went great, but we're going down trackside. We got one excited driver down there.
Cannon, I mentioned it just a minute ago. When we talked to the Wild Card Award, you looked at this banner and we said, hopefully, I'll be here in a couple hours, and you certainly are. But Brian mentioned it. You had to earn that one, and it kind of a statement win for you last year. People said maybe a fluke. This year, you said, no, not a fluke. Does that kind of go through your mind right now? Statement win?
Yeah, it was kind of going through my mind throughout the day. You know, we had a good heat race, and I was just thinking to myself, man, I just got to be consistent to show these guys that it wasn't just a run last day. And, you know, the car was on the rail tonight. I had to keep working well together to get that thing validated. And, you know, it just shows the hard work everyone puts in to be able to come do this 2 times in a row. And, you know, we had to move around and time for that one quite a bit. And, I just got to thank everyone that's with me. And, you know, I thank God as well, you know, my family and this whole team. And, so everyone's behind me.
How big was that late caution? We saw Blake Vaughn moving on the bottom and really starting to challenge Tyler Courtney for a second and coming towards you. And then the yellow flew, and you guys got a chance to maybe slip that bottom out. And I saw you went to the top a couple of laps after the green and then switched down to the bottom side of the racetrack. You really found a lot of success down there.
Yeah, I see Tyler starting to poke the nose there at 3 and 4. And I knew that bottom was good there early, and then it kind of moved back up to the top. So I just went back down there to protect him. I don't know how close they were at the end, but I felt like we were really good at the end. Just sticking the bottom off the floor and hitting the top pretty long on it too. So I'm just proud of this whole team. You know, we worked hard for this.
Here at Chili Bowl, your prelim night, how tough is it to make that decision to leave the top side that's treated you so well all race long and really change your line and go down to an unknown commodity, the bottom of the racetrack?
Yeah, it's definitely risky. You look up at that screen and sometimes you're lagging, you know, you think what you're seeing on there is what they're doing, but you know, it just really gets to your head. And I trusted the screen that time. I think I seen Tyler coming up on me there down the front stretch that one time, and I just knew I had to move and do something different.
Back-to-back prelim wins. Congrats, Cannon.
Thank you.
Cannon McIntosh, back-to-back prelim wins here at Cummins tonight at the Chili Bowl. He's locked into the main event, and we'll find Sunshine Tyler Courtney and get him to the stage.